Shalom, welcome back. First and foremost, I want to give all glory, praises, and honors to Yahweh, Bashem, Yahweh Shai. I want to give double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone and salutations to you acumenists pushing this truth in sincerity. Today's lesson is going to be a testimony about a dream that I had. Now, I'm telling this story because it kind of got me, a little bit shaken up. I'm only going to... there really isn't any such thing as what people perceive as free will, right? There really isn't anything like that. And also, the Lord is allowing us to live, all right? The Lord is allowing us to live, you know? I'll figure out after what I'm going to call this lesson. But anyway, the testimony about this dream. This dream was about a week ago. I had a dream about a horrific car accident, right? And the accident was about the people or the family that my wife works for. She watches their children. And come to find out, these people were taking a road trip and they were going to be driving, all right? Now, before they went out of town, I had this dream that these people were in a horrific car accident and end up dying. And I usually don't have dreams like that. Usually my woman has dreams where she'll see a vision of a person. And then she can actually empathize with the person and feel their emotion. But this had happened to me in the dream that I had, that these people end up dying. And then I could feel my wife's whatever emotion from hearing that type of news. All right. But I saw the accident. I saw their family was wondering why they were so late or missing. But to make a long story short, today, my wife sends me a message. All right. Saying that dream you had, it partly came true. And I was like, what? The dream you had partly came true. These people got in a crazy accident. Car flipped over an embankment. Car totaled, but the Lord allowed these people to live. And really, when she was telling me that the father had told her the story when she had went to work today, that the first responders on the scene was like, they don't know how these people are still alive. So I'm still trying to figure out, you know, the Lord gave me this dream and vision of this thing happening to these people, and it partly happened, but he allowed them to live, which just got me thinking that these people that believe in this free will, I'm gonna do this, I'm gonna do that, at any moment, you know, Yahweh Shai can pull your card. And he showed me that vision that everything is predestined, pre-planned. All right. He allowed this thing to happen. You see? That I had dreamed in my dream. And it played out except for, him taking them. So that kind of got me, you know, a little on edge. But like I said, I usually don't have dreams like that. I know other brothers might experience that more or have visions. And I rarely ever remember my dreams. But this dream right there, you know, is stuck. When it happened, and I ended up telling her that I had it, and she was like, yeah, they driving out of town, this, that, and the other, and it ended up playing out, all right? So I'm going to go right into the scriptures, and that'll be it. Hopefully some edification come out of this. This is the book of Proverbs, chapter 20, verse 24. It says, man's goings are of the Lord. How can a man then understand his own way? Right? So it's kind of like those Final Destination movies where something is meant to happen, it's going to happen. So even with prophecy, even with what you think you're going to be doing in your life, the Lord gives you the illusion of your choice. I always liken it to, you know, picturing your mind a fork, a utensil, a fork you use to eat. You have the handle part, and then you have the four or five prongs at the end of the fork. Now, each of those prongs go what? They lead back into that handle part. Now, any of those prongs could be a choice that you think that you're making, But at the end of the day, you're leading right back to the handle. At the end of the day, you're moving according to Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai's will. All right? So, just understand, man, we are at his mercy, literally. Okay? Let's get this right here. Let's go to the book of Wisdom of Solomon. All right? Chapter 16, verse 12. It says, For it was neither herb nor mollifying plaster that restored them to health, but thy word, O Lord, which healeth all things. For thou hast power of life and death. Thou leadest to the gates of hell and bringest up again. Now, when you go into that word hell, it just simply means grave. When you go into, the Hebrew, and I believe that word is shaul, when you look it up, it literally just means the grave. Let's keep going. Let's get this right here. Let's go to the book. 1 Samuel 2 and 6. It says, the Lord killeth and maketh alive. He bringeth down to the grave and bringeth up. You see that? The Lord maketh poor and maketh rich. He bringeth low and lifteth up. So, you know, what you think you're going to do, what you, you think you're going to desire to accomplish, if it's going to bring you 100% away from your path, the Lord won't allow you to do it, man. He will not allow you to do it. I always make this, say the saying that a certain man and his truth, man, they couldn't fall out this thing if they wanted to, because they have a purpose to fulfill. Just like you go about the Apostle Paul, you know, I remember the saying that, you know, Paul was a chosen vessel, and he must suffer many things, okay? And that goes to say, and that goes to the same for the man, all right? That are here today in their steads, right? Fulfilling what? The lot that Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai gave us, all right? If we're really truly a part of that number, we're going to be a part of this thing. Even in death, I ain't going to go into that, but even in death, we're going to be a part of this thing. Verse 8, he raises up the poor out of the dust and lifted up the beggar from the dunghill to set them among princes and to make them inherit the throne of glory. For the pillars of the earth are the Lord's, and he hath set the world upon them. He will keep the feet of his saints, and the wicked shall be silent in darkness. For by strength shall no man prevail. So sometimes I laugh at these people that, you know, get on TV or, tell you what they're going to be doing in year 2030, year 2040. I'm going to have this, I'm going to do this, Now realizing that, like I said, we are all at the mercy of Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai. All of us, man. So that's something that you have to really consider, you know? To have a dream, a random dream about an accident about these people that I don't know, you know, my girl worked for them. And to have it happen, it's it's something else, man. It's something else. You can't just sit back and think about it. Like, man. The Lord, the Lord is a fearful power. He is a fearful power. Let's keep going. Let's get this right here. So like you hold fast. This is the book of Job 33 and 14. It says, for the Most High speaketh once, yea twice, yet man perceiveth not. In a dream, in a vision of the night, when deep sleep falleth upon man, and slumbering upon the bed, then he openeth the ears of man, and sealeth their instruction. Right? The Lord can give you a vision, he can give you a dream, he can pour out his spirit, which is what he's doing in these end days, on all his people. Alright? To see things, to know things, to feel things, and you know, and just in general, man, heavy death is coming, man. Heavy death is coming, without a shadow of a doubt. There's a lot of people out here is playing. The Lord is done playing. All right. I had a brother after the Lion. You know, we went back to watch a UFC fight. And the brother Shikaria was saying some things, man. It was some things I needed to hear, man. You know, we just do this work and we do it, but really appreciate it, really understand that this is a great privilege to be a part of this thing. All right. Because at any moment, man, the Lord can he can take spirit away from you, or he could just take you out, man. All right. You know, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's, man. So just, you know, keep that in the back of your head. The move that you make, you know, is it glorifying Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai at the end of the day? Let's see what else I got. Let's end it in, we'll end it in Romans. This is the book of Romans, chapter 9, verse 11. And this is just an account about Jacob and Esau, but I'm bringing this out to show you the mindset and power of Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai. It is not of us. All right, it is not of us. Romans 9:11. For the children being not yet born, neither having done any good or evil, the purpose of the Most High according to election might stand, not of works, but of him that calleth. It was said unto her, the elder shall serve the younger, as it is written, Jacob have I loved, but Esau have I hated. What shall we say then? Is there unrighteousness with the Most High? Most High forbid. For he saith to Moses, I will have mercy on whom I will have mercy. And I will have compassion on whom I will have compassion. Right. So the Lord allowed these people that my girl worked for to live, because I know she was worked up in a dream, because I felt her emotion after hearing their death. You know, and women are even more emotional than men. But I don't know if sometimes you try to figure out why the Lord gave you that dream, you know, to begin with. Like, show me that I could have took them people. I fulfilled what I said I was going to do. But I allowed them to live, you know, could be for a number of reasons, or just for my girl to still be employed by these people. You know, who knows, right? It says, so then it is not of him that willeth, nor of him that runneth, but of the Most High that showeth mercy. You see that? Because these people, yeah, after she told me the story of how, you know, it happened, the events is something out of a movie. How the baby was crying, choking, then the lady unbuckled her seat to go check on the baby, bumped the husband swerve, you know, off the road, hit something, flips the car. It is crazy. Like, these people should have been out of here, man. But it was mercy showed. It says, for the scripture saith unto Pharaoh, even for the same purpose have I raised thee up, that I might show my power in thee, and that thy name might be declared throughout all the earth. Therefore have he mercy on whom he will have mercy, and on whom he hardeneth. That will say unto me, why doeth yet they find fault? For who have resisted his will? And the Lord's judgments are perfect. Right? The Lord's judgments are perfect. And I'm not going to continue, because it's going to go into the two vessels, one for good, one for evil. Which the vessel of good is the nation of Israel, you Negroes, Hispanics, Native Americans. And the vessel for evil is, pursuant to this, is Esau, the Edomites, right? So-called Caucasians today, right? Who are fulfilling these end-time prophecies right now. But that's the point, man. I just wanted to tell that testimony. Hope some people get some edification out of this. I'm going to say all praises, glories, and honors to Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai. Shalom the next time.